Hello friends, welcome back to Ask Navneet. This is Dr. Navneet Goyal. I'm an internet entrepreneur and a self-taught SEO and marketer. And today I will be talking about how to start a business. And before that, we should be knowing about how to sketch your business plan effectively on the business canvas. Now, before I proceed further, you should be knowing that each and every organization in the world, every viable business, be it a big organization or a small business, needs to have a business model, because the business model basically describes the rationale of how an organization creates, delivers, and captures the value. So, if you want to start a good business, if you want to have a better understanding of entrepreneurship, then you should watch this video till the end, because I will be giving many examples for explaining the 9 basic elements of business canvas in this video. So, let's get started with this. First and the foremost, we'll talk about the customer segment or the target population. Now, what are the customer segments? What is the target population? The target population or the customer segments are those people who might be interested in buying your product or services. You should have a clear-cut idea on how to sketch your target population based on the facts of demographics, social, and geographic characteristics. You should know who are they and why should they be interested in your product or services? Because every organization must make a conscious decision about which segments to serve and which segments to ignore. You cannot go on following each and every customer selling your product. Now, the second point is value proposition. The value proposition is actually the product or the service which you are selling. In other words, a value proposition is something that solves the customer's problem or satisfy a customer's need. The third is channels. Channel is the mechanism of delivering your product or the value proposition to the customer segment. It can be physical channels, which is an offline store with salespeople, or shipping methods for an online e-commerce store, or downloading method for the information products like ebooks, software, songs, and movies. The fourth is customer relationships. Now, this is a tricky part because it is divided again into 3 phases. The first phase is the lead acquisition. The lead acquisition is how to acquire more customers, how to get people on my website and do something like sign up or book now. The second point is customer retention. How to keep the existing customers within reach. It is very essential to keep your customers engaged so that they buy your product or services later. And the third part is lead conversion. This is where you should make them buy your services or products. What you should do to your customers to keep coming back for more purchases. This is called boosting sales or upselling. The fifth is revenue streams. Revenue streams means how do you actually make money from your product or services? What value will the customer pay for? Is it a direct sale or is it a payment gateway transaction? What model it is? Is it a freemium pattern, a premium, or something else like licensing or subscription model? You should always remember that it is not about the pricing tactics. It's just about how will you make money? What is the model which will generate money for you? The sixth is key resources. The key resources describes the most important assets required to build a business model work. Resources can be categorized into physical, intellectual, human, and financial. The physical resources can be like infrastructure, vehicles, logistics, machines, and inventories. The intellectual resources can be like patents, copyrights, customer databases, etc. Human can be like workforce or manpower, which includes the skilled workforce. And the financial, as you all know, is the capital, which is the key resource. The seventh is key activities. The key activities describes the most important things a company must do to make its business model work. In short, the key activities are the most important activities to run the business. Like, is it the manufacturing of the product, the currency exchange, the delivering of the supplies or transportation, consultation, teaching, or anything else? So if you are a t-shirt manufacturing company, then the basic key activity for your company would be production of the t-shirts. Similarly, if you are running a consultancy business, then the key activity of your business would be problem solving. Suppose you are a payment gateway, so the key activity of your payment gateway would be doing transactions. Earth is key partnerships. The key partnerships describes the network of suppliers and partners that make the business model work. Finally, we come down to the cost structure or the expenses. You have to determine the expenses to run your business. You have to understand the most important costs that are needed to operate your business model. You should categorize the key activities which are most expensive. And you should be able to differentiate the expenses into two varieties. The first is the fixed cost and the latter is variable cost. This completes our large poster sized version of the business model canvas. These 9 basic building blocks of a business model will show the logic of how a company intends to make money. Hope you must have liked this video.
If you have liked this video, do subscribe to this channel for more such awesome updates. Do share, like, and comment in the column below, and I would be more than happy to reply you back. Thanks for watching this video. Goodbye.